Hello, welcome to the new chapter of Vidya Mandir Academy. That's your important paper of development paper, economic development paper. That's a big push theory, very, very important theory. That's given by Professor N. Rosenstein Rodan. That's a big push theory. That minimum push that required in our day-to-day life, as well as in the developing economy of the world, that minimum investment is required for the development of the nation, that high minimum investment is required for the development of the nation. So most of the underdeveloped nation and developing nation should adopt the big push theory for the development of their nation. So you people see the aerodrome field is there, and you see there's a high slope of the aerodrome field. When the runway is there, that gradually slope upward. That minimum force, that minimum high force that required to push up the aeroplane to upward, or upward push of the aeroplane, like that. In our regular development of the economy, there's a minimum investment in overhead capital, there's the development of the individuality of demand, individuality of supply of saving, and creation of social overhead capital that make the development of the economy. That is given by the Professor Rosenstein Rodan. According to him, there's a three individualities are there. Individualities in social overhead capital, that individuality in demand side, and individuality in supply of saving side, that those factors are responsible for the big push of the economy, that bring the underdeveloped and developing economy into the right track of development, that minimum investment is a necessary one to bring it in the right track. Now let us come to the topic, the big push theory, very important theory. That big push, that means you see that minimum investment is required to push up the economy to upward, developing economy and underdeveloping economy into the developed economy. That minimum investment is required. Now come to the topic, that's given by Professor N. Rosenstein Rodan. This theory is proposed by Professor Rosenstein Rodan, and according to him, a high minimum amount of investment is required to overcome the obstacle of underdeveloped economy to make it develop, launching a country a self-sustaining growth in little like an aeroplane off the ground. So he is comparing the take-off of aeroplane. The take-off of aeroplane requires some minimum push-up. That you people see the aerodrome field, that continuous after moving up some distance, that you see upward sloping of the aerodrome field, that's the minimum push-up is there to push up, to move up of the aeroplane, that aeroplane move into the sky, that minimum push-up. Like that, in developing economy and underdeveloped economy, minimum high investment is required to make the economy develop from the underdeveloped and developing economy, that remove all type of obstacle, all type of difficulties of the economy only by the process of investment. That investment is the very important thing. What he has given the idea, that minimum high investment is required. And next one, N. Rosenstein Rodan found three individualities and external economies. First, individualities of production function, individuality of production function, individuality of inputs, and individuality of output that bring the increasing return. Do you know what is increasing return? That is less investment and output will increase in a faster rate. If by giving the less input, we are getting faster, much more output. Suppose we are giving the input that is 30% and output is there 80%, that's we are getting the increasing return. So increasing return is there. How increasing return is there? If there is, that's so individuality of production function, individuality of input, individuality of output, then we are getting the increasing return. That investment in social overhead capital, like power, transport, and communication, that's a three factor is there. So What's the investment? Investment of the economy in power, transport and communication, that social overhead capital. In the long period, there's a lumpy investment is there. In the long period, there we observe, it has having long gestation period. We are having the great return out of this capital because we are considering the closed economy, no export and import. So in the closed economy, what actually happened? These factors are not importable factor. We cannot import this factor like power, transport and communication. The investment in such factor, investment in such overhead capital that make the economy in the right track, to bring the economy into the right track, it remove all type of obstacle, all type of difficulties of the economy, of developing economy and underdeveloped economy, to bring it in the right track and the investment promote. So investment in such economy that very useful, investment in such sector that very useful to develop trade, commerce, business in the economy, to make it a developed economy. And second point, the individuality of demand requires a simultaneous setup of the independent industries. So you see that what he has given the idea. There is 10,000 unemployed people are there in the economy, and simultaneously there are set up 100 industries in the economy. So what happened? The producer of one industry become the consumer of other industry. So the labor, the workers of industry, what they are getting wages, they are spending in for purchase of goods and services. And where they purchase? They purchase from the other industry. So you see that the producer of one industry become the consumer of another industry. So simultaneous setup of group of industries in the economy make the economy develop. This is the individuality of demand. So individuality of demand and that bring the minimum quantum of investment that bring the economy into the developed economy. So you see the establishment of selected industry or one or two industries in the nation cannot make it develop. So a group of industries in the nation that because that create the individuality of the demand of industries. So individuality of demand, that's very important factor, because what the labor are getting in the form of wages or salary, they spend to purchase their daily requirement. Where they will purchase? They will purchase in the economy, because we are assuming that they are the closed economy. So the simultaneous establishment of a lot of industry in the economy that make the economy developed. The individuality of demand, that's very important factor for the making of development of the economy. It is the individuality of demand which necessitates a high minimum quantum of investment in interdependent industries. So interdependent, one industry depend upon another. Interdependent industries. So what will happen? As there are the interdependent industries are in the economy, so what happened there? So their minimum investment that bring the economy into the large investment and large growth of the economy. And next one, individual supply of saving. High income elasticity of saving is required for the investment in the developing economy. It is really difficult to achieve saving in developing economy, but high minimum saving is required to promote investment in the nation. So you see that if the saving will be promoted, if the people which accustomed with saving, they save the money, that there the capital formation is there. And as there the capital formation is there, their investment will be definitely there. More investment, that you see the, if all the people save something out of their income, then that promote the investment in the economy. So more investment, that means investment promote, saving promote investment, and investment promote the nation. So these three factors are three indivisibilities are there to make the big push theory. That big push from the small investment, from the small force, we come to the big one. And that's the idea is given by Professor N. Rogester Rodan. And he is comparing the takeoff of the aeroplane with the moving upward of the nation. by that takeoff. How the takeoff taken place? By the minimum force there, like that minimum investment is there, and he is taking the three type of individuality. First one, individuality in overhead capital. Second one, individuality of demand. And third one, individuality of supply of saving. These three factors are responsible for the upward movement of the economy by the investment. And he is giving different idea that investment in different channel, which we are comparing, considering the closed economy system. Investment in power, investment in transport and communication, because those are not importable. So, set up a group of industry, that's a very important one for the development of the economy. But this theory also criticized by certain economics, certain critics are also there. And what are that critics? Negligible economics from investment in export and import, because this theory is silent regarding the export and import substitute. Why it is? Because you are comparing, we are considering the closed economy system, not the open economy system. So this theory is silent regarding the import substitution or export substitution, because of there is no open economy. Next, negligible economics even from the cost reducing investment. It is also not considering the cost reducing investment system. Third one, neglect investment in the agricultural sector. This theory is silent regarding the investment in the agricultural sector. Now, the demand of agricultural food is very high in the international market, and most of the developing nations are exporting the food material to other nations of the world. And most of the agro-based industries are there, where it is getting the raw material from the agricultural sector. But this theory is silent regarding this one. So, you people understand this one? What's the big push theory? According to the big push theory, that minimum quantum of investment is required for the development of the underdeveloped and developing nation of the world. I think all of you understand. If there is any query or doubt, you may ask.